technology tools and activity we have going on. Any of this you want to know, and it's part of Critical Services team, and we work together on technology stuff. Right, this is products and technology, some of the ones I have, the NAVE for message ID, company software bus network, the multi-core, modeling and auto code, real-time partitioning, like our data sheet, post-out PSP layer, Charlie Star, and really, we have a couple early adopters for some of these things, but we're looking for missions, people to take the next step. We'll subsidize, take money to move to class C or class B or class A. And so we're something that's going to be how we get developed here within NASA. Message namespace, the current way we do our topics in the software module, we do a use of description, we use of the rewriting to the 2011 app ID within a CGFDF packet. And we want a larger number to increase the namespace. 2011 sounds like a lot, but when we get the distributed systems and just managing namespace, there's issues that come up. I'm chair within standard or standard onboard interface services working through, and some say in the option of standard writing standards. Yeah, we're going to standardize on a secondary header that will include these new namespace conditions. And we're trying, the next 6 months or so for the development of this. I'm actually working this mission, or not promoting this mission, and that's why you get the technology used. It's a science, or maybe. So quite a bit of effort to bring up the class B with all the standard regression tests, all the functional tests, and the process. We get through some of that process for the cooling mission, but not all of it. Good demonstration for the bring up the TRL level. One of the ways we're talking about doing it, I think it's already been in the slides, maybe some part of these slides, but not necessarily all. But through the 16th or 2011, I'm going to do the 2-4 and distribute that a little bit. This to the application, for most applications, it requires some changes to some applications. Applications that need a global nationwide namespace, like if there's only one telemetry system, describing telemetry from different processes for even different spacecraft. When you talk about that, I have a CubeSat with a big and the other ones have little local omnis, a network to connect them, which is already been demonstrated. And then one big one pumps them down to Earth, in which case, subscribe to CubeSat 1, CubeSat 2, CubeSat 3. The vehicle set is where this comes into play. Applications would have to change to incorporate the new namespace, but the old namespace stay in place as well. This got to work is just getting a very efficient implementation of this new change. It's a simple thing. One of the things worth noting is that in this new header, published message, you can go with ending this. It was published on, if you need to translate that on the receiving side, you can. Advantage or capabilities in your archive data sheet, which is one of the other technologies I'll talk about. So these are the before and after of those definitions. These are that are in work. That we're supported with IRAM. We have a bottom and leave the software bus 1. There's a 422 and there's a 485 version. There's Ethernet on time and shared memory is a new one, and then wireless was demonstrated on the interested in that. So it will actually move from one local, one network interface to the other network interface without going up the stack. It's getting further than that. It's part of it would be deployed on the IFS safety NIT experiment mini, they call it ISEN.
Is it fair? So Johnson's working on one too, or is it kind of safe?
We have to somehow reconcile if we have different versions. I think. Okay.
Versions with different layers.
Oh, okay.
Well, I guess I was just saying, is this available for other people to use? It sounds like you've done a lot of work in this area, and I'd like it to be available to the community.
I think you hit on the main point of having this discussion with this set of charts, is these are the things we're working on, and then
right.
So people think I'm working on that too. Which I have to actually go through an NPR release process to get this out.
Right, but that is better to center trying to be too, because I think a lot of bullet there.
QoS is addressed because the local, which is can't copy memory from here to there. We got bigger problems than priority and reliability. You know, your system's gone down. But QoS is playing where you're talking about going off card or between two, you know, processors or processes in a Linux file or something like that. So we can't use memory space. Piece of that, which is the slave, the software bus network, the contributor architecture, so that they're messaged divide consistently across the environment, which is part of what you want for deterministic systems and fault tolerant systems. Allows you to scale across multiple nodes and have them act in a deterministic way. We worked, I guess it was like years ago. There's some changes that we have incorporated that haven't gone through the CCB yet about there. Support that our 10 support is coming for SMP. So we need, which shouldn't affect applications, but are going to affect the OSAL and some executive services, processor affinity, dispatching applications to different cores, and managing the process synchronization, spin lock, those kinds of things. Need to be addressed, and at the executive service level and the operating director as well. The core Rad Hard Leons is Rad and spent over 2 years, likely 3 years, is sort of a position that would want to push that to the next level, a near term need. Community has worked is missions have to pick something up. We can prototype stuff under IRAD funding and then have to pick it up to go to the next level. And that's what we're doing. So you'll get a class.
So, don't look at me and say A, please.
Yeah, but stepwise you find it. Until a real mission comes on, then you gotta have these dual cores. It's not gonna happen. Something to help with this is there's currently a NASA Air Force effort that's funded in FY16. We did a study in the early that ended on 2015. Our ship was ARM-A53, it's a little block diagram, the sort of generic version of it. I can't show the computer at this point. Funding in 16 and 17 to do the software and middleware development. So that's a life path, also additional funding to support the ESP development for this particular car. Anderson, you know, like everybody's weather, so people know these things are out there. It was simulating models into template CFS compliance. So they do things, they hit a button, it spits out an application that's loadable just like any other CFS application. It was developed and used for Latty, for that guy. And that open source, in my understanding. It's going to be out there in the community because it's a good business for any kind of control system or modeling. It's a preferred another instrument. IFS, and I guess a year from now. So it's I think, for ISO. And Latty was class B as well.
The software.
Okay. So the margin there of B quality. We're looking at our real analytics. Email addresses for people who might make comments out there. dictionary a term which defines sort of common things like, you know, in 15, what does sub-address mean? So when you're dealing with a sub-network, then in the data sheet, you can define sub-address 20 is this, and here's the data content for the sub-address. The data specify all that for hardware components. You can also specify which I talked about earlier.
How is that the CCFTF with?
So is that, I can't remember the color scheme. And then
it's blue, which means it's actually, it's a real standard. They develop quite a few tools. Those tools aren't compatible with ours because they don't use a messaging system like we do. But they're not there yet.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
You already gave the EDS defining, like, this. I don't know, I'm loud enough.
Yeah,
but you mentioned the EDS, like the sub-address 20 is the data format. The thought here, like a lot of times you might have stack messages where you might have, you know, five transactions with a schedule for some RFP sub-address 20 would all be different pieces of an overall larger message.
Concept of having an aggregator for different 50-degree lines into one packet. So it's kind of like that becomes it. And that's something easy. Not actually nothing. I think using it for their tool chain for their Babwar, which is very similar to CFS. So the Europeans have a version of this. JPL has a version of the CFS. You know, because it makes sense to use kind of reusable. In the iPad lab, since he's not a GNC guy, he's working on SysML autocode to generate the data files, which then generate the header. So that's kind of trying to integrate all that together and see which tools make sense and what the path, the long term path for the CFS community is going to work. So, mission options we have not yet already been put into the
into
stable cache, but they have not been adopted.
When is the
rule book? I think I reviewed in the DARM meeting, which is like 3 weeks from now or 2 weeks. We'll go to this position and we get it fixed and put it out. The one in the book is MTS, which is the CCS. Work on that, and we have the hooks in there to get that in there. So we're writing to get that in there. And then that's really the software part that we want from a software perspective, but the hardware people want for the subnetwork version. The subnetwork, the 1553 layer, you have a data sheet, the hardware manufacturer gives that to you for, say, a tracker or something. If they're using 1553 or SpaceWire or something like that, by some driver and brought up, and then it publishes a bus message with the data definitions, like engineering conversions, all those things, and put it up the stack and get off a bus message. But now it's got a header and other stuff, and the aggregation going on. That gets pushed out and is used for the software application. And on this other CCF, yes, that's called XTCE, which incorporates the pieces for that and then the database. And then, you know, it's colored on it, you know, this temperature, and the gray one is this temperature. They have something right on that we don't need to display. So it's sort of laying out on the TSP and the OSA implementation, so you can have different examples of different OSALs that are independent and relatable. That told you they means all the OSALs all at once. We call it conversion next. We can say VX works OSAL instantiation. Here's bartender instantiation. That's separate thing. I mean, separate deliverables independently. The only thing we have to really worry about, not anything, but as long as the API doesn't change, all these things plug in from the bottom for different operating systems. Like when you get a free RTOS that's been working on, a separate release. They don't have to fund you release this one thing. So less the better will help in that area and make hold the process. Let's just from all the other views on the thing. We're going in this direction. Pull out a common parameter checking and common code, and then which is separate from the actual implementation of all OS, which is there for a particular OS or the extraction one. Some protocol here, but it's only for Linux. So you have to do that for VxWorks and RTEMS and all the other things. So not sure you might pick that up. And there's steps for the TSC is being able to separate words and have them independently list. Yep. Just the way you lay out a directory structure in the interface is what you need to think about making it easier to release when you think it isn't. Guard is another service that's required for if you have redundant systems. Test it takes 3 weeks to run a mission scenario, being able to stop the process and tweak or change something and start up again from where you pick off. So there's the capability to support those. Maybe some that has to go into executive service and get them some preliminary design. I know all the checkpoint restart, and you had to incorporate that somewhat into your development effort for the airline vehicle. So those changes back in. So the TBD and mission adoption, we would pick that up with TBD. Quick set of things, there's probably many others out there that people would want to see in next versions of CFS, but that's a quick one. Let me go into it next. Questions on that, or any suggestions for technologies that users would want to see?
One question, what happens, so to get these developmental efforts to the point where you want to sort of them into the mainstream, I guess, for lack of a better word, mission adoption to sort of promote funding sometimes, right? So what happens to the stuff that doesn't get stuff by mission?
So we have to do prototype code. Most of these already have prototype code. And they talked briefly about this development tree, which is independent. It's available, and the idea that it's consistent. Everything in that tree works. It just is at the same level. A little bit over here. I don't know if it works with this little over here or this little bit. You want to make sure you're not getting that state. So the development tree, and then there's the formal tree or the independent. We'll pull those back in the missions adopted. Some of them take a little bit of a lot of natural land at this state of emergency, no mission wants it. Then we pick the wrong technology. Any other questions?
So, this is in the
car integration test, so that on certain vehicles that would be of interest. So basically, I guess we don't initially break you, or probably stay farther ahead of GCC and tools than you guys are likely to as well. That's something long term that's of interest, just something we think is interesting.
It'd be very good for early adopters of technology, because it's going through your type of procedure, not necessarily. So, and people will be very happy to be able to say, this version of FS works well with this newer version of RTEPS.
Right, that's what
that's
I think we'd be on the open source version, pulling it down, and then basically be able for at least the BSPs that are supported. And I know Alan's got a few in his back pocket that eventually will see the light.
You be developing the PSPs also, or only testing with the OPAL?
I test everything we can test for the unit test.
Testing only.
Testing. I don't
have the resources to, as I get it.
We, our town probably doesn't have the resources to support sort of the PSP development for OSAL necessarily. Unless someone already aligned with our town decides, okay, now I'm also a PSSP. But we're always happy to include testing of something that's using our time for how do you embed our time in something and test it.
CNS, I mean, is a core user group. It kind of makes sense for us to be on ourselves and beat on you guys in case something actually breaks, or we break something accidentally that breaks you, which is pretty unlikely, but it's just kind of keep it in future proof. And then Alan looks into the future where he's playing catch up now for a couple of years of development. He's having to integrate new features. It might, but you knew it was coming, so it won't. You're overworked and underpaid, so that won't change that, will it?
Okay, so what was that again?
Next is our first user.